The Hospital, an Institution of Hope. A Sanctuary for the Sick and Injured. A Guardian of Precious Human Life. It is here that a mother first meets her newborn child. And it is here where many draw their last breath. In India, the quality of medical care in major cities is world-class. Hospitals in the private sector provide modern medical facilities, where complex treatments such as stem cell transplants, heart, and brain surgeries are performed daily. Yet, these hospitals serve only 28% of the Indian population. What happens to the millions of people who cannot afford basic health care, who have no access to medical help for even the most common ailments? Where can they go? Who will help them? Moved by the plight of mankind, the Lord sends His beloved messengers into the world to spread the teachings of truth. And while doing so, these loving saints do everything in their power to ease human suffering. One such mystic was the spiritual master of Radhaswami Satsang Bias, Maharaj Charan Singh, who later came to be known as Hazur Maharaji. It was his selfless love for humanity that led to the establishment of the Maharaj Jagat Singh Medical Relief Society in 1978, a charitable trust dedicated to providing free medical care to all those in need, irrespective of caste, creed, status, income, or religion. Over the years, the Maharaj Jagat Singh Medical Relief Society has built 4 charitable hospitals in different locations in rural India to meet the medical needs of the surrounding population. In addition to free medical care, the Society offers relief and aid to victims who have been affected during major calamities in India. The Society has chosen the field of healthcare to express its core philosophy: love for the Creator and His creation. Hazur Maharaji often said, "The Lord is in everyone." Through the selfless service offered by these charitable hospitals, the Society conveys a profound and timeless message that by caring for the Lord's beloved children of all ages and backgrounds, we are loving the Lord Himself in His many diverse forms. The Society's first effort can be traced back to the early 1960s, when India was at war. There was an acute shortage of blood throughout the country. To help those in need, Hazur Maharaji announced the opening of a blood donation camp at the Dera. When the Sangat was told that anyone who donated blood could consider it as a seva or selfless service, the response was overwhelming. The number of donors was so high that many had to be turned away. The Blood Bank Society did not have the capacity to collect so much blood at one time. Hazur Maharaji once recalled the time when the blood bank sent a message inquiring whether it was human blood, because they could not believe that there could be so many people donating blood at one time. In 1964, during his satsang tours in India, it came to Hazur Maharaj's attention that a large part of the rural population were suffering from cataract, the most common cause of blindness in the world. Millions of people were suffering from loss of vision due to this disease. And although the cure was a simple surgical procedure, many could not afford it, nor were there enough eye hospitals to cater to the huge numbers suffering from this condition. This tragic situation moved Hazur Maharaj to set up the first Dera Eye Camp in February 1965, where cataract operations and other treatments for eye disease were provided to the public completely free of charge. From then on, for the next 38 years, in the month of November, the Dera Eye Camp was an annual event. For 15 days, a huge wave of loving, enthusiastic sevadars, in the form of doctors, nurses, and thousands of non-medical volunteers, swept into the Dera to help restore sight to the vision impaired. The depth of kindness and human compassion that radiated from the Dera Eye Camp had to be seen to be believed. It's been said that to talk about love may be noble, but to transform that love into action is divine. A doctor relates one of the many compassionate incidents that took place during the eye camp.
One incident in particular was very inspiring. We were doing the rounds one night when an old man became a little short of breath and sat up in the bed. We made sure that there was nothing wrong with the heart or the lungs. And it appeared that he was uncomfortable in the new surroundings. So the sevadar then pacified him and he was ready to go back to sleep. But the poor chap had to sit up again in a very short time. And we found that he was a little more comfortable if he was sitting up. But it was difficult for him to go to sleep in that position. So then this sevadar, who was in charge of that particular patient, sat with his back supporting the back of the patient and leaning a little forward so that the patient could lean against his back. And lo and behold, within a very short period of time, the patient went back to sleep. He needed to catch some sleep because he was due for surgery next morning. The sevadar kept on sitting like that, in that very stooped position, for the next 3-4 hours, just so that the old man could catch some sleep. And that's why when the patients ultimately after surgery are discharged, when this particular old man was asked to go, he had tears in his eye and he found it very difficult to tear himself away from this sevadar who had been looking after him much better than his own family or children could have done.
This is what Hazur Maharaj inspired his sevadars to do.
Whosoever comes for seva, naturally he has a devotion and a love for the Lord. Otherwise, why should he waste his time and energy? He is full with love and devotion for the Father, and he wants to help the humanity in which the Father lives. That is their background of every sevadar. So they do it for love. They don't do it for their ego or for any other gain. Just to eliminate their ego, they are serving everybody. And the people who come for operation, they have their own problems, you see. Because they don't get such service anywhere else, such facilities anywhere else. So the people come here for that help.
The highlight of the camp was the master's visit. Hazur Maharaj would come to the eye camp 2 or 3 times a day to visit the patients and personally check on their progress. His presence was inspiring and brought immense joy to both the patients and the sevadars serving them. Once, addressing the volunteers who had assembled to receive prasad, Hazur Maharaj expressed his love and appreciation for their devotion to the patients.
Baba Ji Maharaj ne, Sri Hazur Maharaj Ji ne, is tere di vyaad, keval prem pyar, nimrata ji, seva aur bhajan se barabar rakhi hai. Aur is tere andar sab barabar hai. Ameer ho gaye, gareeb ho gaye, aurat ho gaye, aadmi ho gaye, kise kaum na ho gaye, kise mazhab na ho gaye, kise burj na ho gaye, koi jaat paat ka sawal. ਸਾਡਾ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਹੈ, ਹਰ ਇੱਕ ਸਤਸੰਗੀ ਦਾ ਹੈ, ਜਿਸ ਪ੍ਰੇਮ ਪਿਆਰ ਨਾਲ ਸੰਗਤ ਸੇਵਾਦਾਰ ਹਰ ਸਾਲ ਅੱਖਾਂ ਦੇ ਮਰੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਦੀ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰਦੀ ਹੈ, ਆਈ ਕੈਪ ਅੰਦਰ ਆ ਕੇ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰਦੀ ਹੈ, ਇਹ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਅਸੂਲਾਂ ਦਾ ਹੀ ਇੱਕ ਬੜਾ ਉੱਚਾ ਨਮੂਨਾ ਹੈ, ਜਿਸ ਪ੍ਰੇਮ ਪਿਆਰ ਔਰ ਨਿਮਰਤਾ ਨਾਲ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਇਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਅੱਖਾਂ ਦੇ ਬਿਮਾਰਾਂ ਦੀ ਸੇਵਾ ਕੀਤੀ ਹੈ, ਹਰ ਸਾਲ ਕਰਦੇ ਹੋ, ਮੈਂ ਅਗਰ ਦਮ ਨਹੀਂ ਮਾਰਦਾ ਤਾਂ ਸ਼ਾਇਦ ਹੀ ਦੁਨੀਆਂ ਵਿੱਚ ਐਸੀ ਕੋਈ ਮਿਸਾਲ ਹੋਵੇ। ਮੈਂ ਲੰਬੀ ਤਕਰੀਰ ਕਰਨ ਦਾ ਆਦੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਹਾਂ, ਅੰਤਰ ਕੇਵਲ ਹਜ਼ੂਰ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਜੀ ਅੱਗੇ ਹੱਥ ਜੋੜਨ ਦੀ ਹੀ ਆਦਤ ਹੈ। ਮੈਂ ਹੁਣ ਵੀ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਹੱਥ ਜੋੜਾਂਗਾ ਕਿ ਆਪਣੇ ਸੇਵਾਦਾਰਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਹਰ ਸਾਲ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਦੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਮਰੀਜ਼ਾਂ ਦੀ ਸੇਵਾ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਦੇ ਰਹਿ ਔਰ ਮੇਰੇ ਤੇ ਔਰ ਆਪਣੀ ਸੰਗਤ ਤੇ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਦੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਸੇ ਦਇਆ ਮਿਹਰ ਬਖਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਦੇ ਰਹਿ।
One evening, in a question and answer meeting, Hazur Maharaj Ji said,
"Sister, this whole camp is based on love and service. Dedicated service by doctor, dedicated service by the sevadars, by the technicians, by thing, by everybody. Without dedication, you can't make such a camp a success. And I would rather we feel fortunate that these patients give us opportunity to serve them. Serve, to give, get service is a very rare opportunity to serve anybody. And we are grateful to the patient that they give us opportunity to serve them. So that makes us happy, that makes sevadar happy."
By the late 1970s, there was an influx of patients visiting the eye camp. And due to the lack of resources available, those who had other health complications could not be treated. Consequently, thousands of patients had to be turned away. Their plight weighed heavily on Hazur Maharaj's mind as he thought about how to help these poor people. Compelled by his great desire to provide free medical care throughout the year, in 1980, Hazur Maharaj called for a committee to begin planning the construction of a permanent charitable hospital where, apart from the eye operations, other diseases could also be treated. A site covering 35 acres of land was chosen in the township of Bias, intentionally away from the Dera, so that people receiving free medical treatment would not feel obliged to visit the Dera. A wealthy person once offered Hazur Maharaj a blank check, requesting him to fill in any amount as a donation for the hospital. Hazur Maharaj politely declined. He explained that he wanted this hospital to be built with the love and service of every member of the Sangat. And so, when it was announced that the construction for the hospital was ready to begin, people from all over India volunteered to help, eager to contribute in whatever capacity they could, grateful for the opportunity to serve. Hazur Maharaj was involved in every phase of the hospital construction. He visited the site every day to inspect the work in progress, review plans with engineers, share his vision, and resolve problems. On January 24, 1986, the Bias Hospital opened to the public.
Satsang shuru karan ton pehla main benti karna chahunda ha ki Hazur Maharaj ji di ati daya mehar bakhshish de naal thoda hospital hun taiyar ho gaya. और जिस मेहनत मेहनत और प्यार दे नाल संगत ने इस नु तैयार कीता है उस दे ता शायद ही कोई दुनिया अंदर मसाल होवेगी और ना मेरे पास लफ्ज है कि उस दे मुतलक मैं कुछ बयान कर सका हजार अस्पताल दे स्टाफ नु सिर्फ मैं इतनी ही अर्ज करनी चाहुंदा हां कि मैनेजमेंट जिहड़ी है वो उन्हां दी जरूरतां दा हर किस्म दा ख्याल रखेगी लेकिन हमेशा एक गल नूं वो याद रखण कि जिस हस्ती दी याद विच और जिस दे नाम ते ये हस्पताल बनाया गया है और जिस प्रेम प्यार नाल सत्संगत ने इस नूं खड़ा कीता है उस दे नाम नूं प्रेम प्यार नाल बीमारां दी संगत करके होर उच्चा चुकना है होर रोशन करना है
After the success of the Bias Hospital, in 1988, Hazur Maharaj launched the second charitable hospital project in the small village of Sikandarpur in southern Haryana. Having lived and worked in Sikandarpur, Hazur Maharaj was well aware of the living conditions of the rural Haryana countryside. The villages in the 10 square kilometers surrounding the hospital had no electricity or plumbing, and most of the houses were made of mud. The local villagers were poor agricultural laborers who suffered many health problems and lacked adequate medical care. Most of the construction of this charitable hospital was once again a labor of love carried out by volunteers. Designed by the same team of architects as the Bias Hospital, it is similar in many ways, though on a smaller scale. Built on 19 acres of land, surrounded by lush greenery, it offers relief from the hot, dusty climate, creating an oasis in the midst of the stark agricultural landscape. The third charitable hospital was built in the town of Bahota. Majestically situated on 44 acres, over a scenic highland facing the eastern Himalayas in the Hamirpur district of Himachal Pradesh. Maharaj Sawan Singh, also known as the Great Master, planted the seed of love in this region back in the 1900s when he used to visit this remote area. Often living for many days under harsh conditions, the great master traveled on horseback and on foot, spreading the message of the saints to the simple, loving people of the hills. In 1944, in response to overwhelming requests by the local disciples, the great master gave permission for a satsang hall to be constructed on a plot of barren, rocky land in the small town of Bahota. Under the great master's close supervision, the satsangar turned out to be one of the most stunning architectural structures in the region. Over the years, Hazur Maharaj Ji noticed that many people from Himachal Pradesh were coming to Bias for medical treatment. Conscious of their lack of resources and the grueling commute across the rugged highlands, Hazur Maharaj Ji explored the possibility of building a charitable hospital, either in the town of Paror or Bahota. After careful thought, it was decided that a satsang center would be built in Paror and a hospital would be constructed in the village of Bahota, where access to healthcare was more difficult. By late 1990, phase one of the development of the Bahota Hospital had begun. One of the most difficult tasks was to acquire sufficient contiguous land for such a large-scale project. Plots of land were gradually purchased from local residents. A few years later, when the entire parcel of hospital land was finally obtained, the difficult phase of preparing the grounds began. The rugged terrain was comprised of steep hills and deep ravines, with streams running through it, and was strewn with boulders and rocks. Nevertheless, the architects and engineers were committed to creating a structure that would be functionally efficient, yet conform to the natural contour of the site. Vast quantities of earth and sand were removed from the upper slopes to level hills and fill ravines. The rocky ground was blasted to make way for reinforced concrete tunnels, big enough to drive a car through. Eventually, a configuration of four terraced levels was created from the once steep, uneven hillsides. By July 1996, the land was ready and the final phase of development began. Thousands of people generously gave of themselves, either through donations or physical seva, to build this beautiful hospital, a breathtaking testimony to the power of love. In June 1999, the Bahota Hospital opened its doors to the public. The three charitable hospitals cater to approximately 2 million people from 1,700 villages, who otherwise would not have had access to quality medical care. Each hospital serves a population living within a radius of approximately 25 kilometers, with first aid services available to anyone in need. These hospitals provide outpatient care and inpatient facilities with over 500 beds. On an annual basis, in total, over 600,000 outpatients are treated, and over 20,000 inpatients are admitted in these hospitals. Emergency services are also available. The hospitals conduct, on average, approximately 25,000 surgeries annually. all hospitals maintain strict sterilization procedures, resulting in very low operative and post-operative infections.
So the four hospitals that we have, including the one in Dera, are all set up in areas that are very rural, with populations that have to go very far to get quality healthcare facilities or healthcare facilities at all in some cases. The structure is very simple. It takes care of a local population. It's demarcated a certain set of villages in within a certain mileage. And it gives completely free of cost healthcare, as also facilities post-discharge, including medication, as also follow-up visits. The objective really is to take care of any needs that they have up to secondary care facilities, whether it is from a birthing perspective or from a clinical or from an emergency need, they're taken care of within these facilities. Obviously, there are times when they have more urgent clinical requirements that we are not able to offer in our healthcare facilities. And we have a very good working relationship with other public and private hospitals in the neighborhood, even far off to metros if and when required, where we can refer patients. And very often, even those institutions, because of the relationship that we have and they understand that we're a charitable organization and the patients that we are sending probably can't afford their care, even do subsidize or even free care at some times. So it's not just what we're doing locally, but so to say an ecosystem that is kind of developed around that area that even other people who are not linked to the hospital per se are able to pitch in and help the people who are in need.
This is the Bias Hospital. Every morning from 5 o'clock onwards, as many as 1,200 patients come here to seek medical attention. In the waiting room, each patient is assessed and assigned to a specific doctor for treatment upon registration. This registration system takes place in the same manner in both the Sikandarpur and Bahota hospitals. All the hospitals under the society provide care in general surgery, internal medicine, gynecology, ENT, ophthalmology, and pediatrics. The hospitals also have dental and physiotherapy services. Because the Bias Hospital has access to a number of specialist doctors, additional services are also provided, including cardiology, urology, gastroenterology, oncology, dermatology, pulmonary care, and orthopedic services. In addition, obstetrics and neonatal care are also provided. The gynecology and obstetrics department at the Bias Hospital cares for approximately 25,000 patients annually. The Bias Hospital also has an intensive care unit and a critical care unit where patients with life-threatening conditions are treated. The hospitals have a well-equipped radiology department and a laboratory that conducts tests for hematology, biochemistry, microbiology, serology, clinical pathology, and histopathology. In addition, these three hospitals have a blood bank and a well-stocked pharmacy where patients are provided free medicines. To support the hospital staff, approximately 130 sevadars from different satsang centers serve at the Bias Hospital on a voluntary basis. They help in various departments such as sanitation, horticulture, as well as helping patients who require assistance and many other such duties. All the charitable hospitals under the society conform to the principles of the Sant Mat philosophy. For this reason, only lacto-vegetarian food and non-alcoholic beverages are provided on the premises. Seminars are regularly held for doctors and medical staff, keeping them informed and up to date on current medical advancements. Doctors have the opportunity to use this platform to share their learning experiences with colleagues. One of the senior mentors at the Bias Hospital is Dr. Balwant Singh Tung. For 3 decades, Dr. Tung conducted thousands of surgeries at Amritsar Medical College, where he served as principal and head of surgery. He then went on to serve as director of medical education and research for the state of Punjab, which is the highest position for a medical teacher. In 1989, Dr. Tung joined the Bias Hospital as chief surgeon. With his outstanding surgical skills and stellar reputation, he has been a great inspiration to the many generations of doctors serving at the Bias Hospital. What stands out in these hospitals is the doctor-patient relationship. The doctors who have chosen to offer their time towards this noble cause work shoulder to shoulder with one goal: to serve their fellow man with the spirit of love and compassion.
विनती है कि इसका रखरखाव हमने बहुत खूब करना है, ठीक है? बीच में तकलीफ हो, बीच में नहीं तो एक हफ्ते बाद आके देखेंगे, ठीक है?
ठीक है सर। मेरे लिए तो जी भगवान की है, जैसे भगवान है ना, ऐसे ही डॉक्टर सर।
I would think that the guiding principle would be that we offer whatever services we have here to the patients who come to us with compassion and love and kindness, considering them as our very valued guests, which is very appropriate, because if there is no patient, there is no doctor, and if there is no patient being treated, there is no nurse required. So actually, if you look at it, the patient is the reason for existence, for the doctor, the nurse, and all the infrastructure which is there. We in this hospital try to hold the patient as the fundamental unit. He is the reason for our existence. So as a result, we have to look after them with love and care. By the Lord's grace, whatever staff we have here, they have come here with the clear understanding that serving the sick person is their seva. And as a result, their attitude is very different from whatever you would find in many of the other hospitals.
That's a worship, mere bahut ka pyar rakhde hai. Bachcha magar mera pyar rakhde
bahut. Assi thode seva vaste hi hai mata ji itthe. Ha, koi fikr na.
A nurse shares her experience of working at the Bias Hospital.
मेरे को यहाँ 29 ईयर्स हो गए हैं. मैंने बहुत ज़्यादा लर्न किया है. डॉक्टर जोशी ने मेरे को बहुत ज़्यादा सिखाया है. अपने कुलीग से, सीनियर कुलीग से बहुत ज़्यादा लर्न किया है. वार्ड हेल्पर, डॉक्टर्स, नर्सिंग सबका टीम वर्क है. अगर अकेले हम यहाँ काम नहीं कर सकते, टीम वर्क ही काम होता है. विद लव एंड अफेक्शन के साथ यहाँ सारे काम करते हैं, तो जब हम उनसे प्यार करते हैं तो उनकी आधी बीमारी वैसे ही ठीक हो जाती है. कोई डिफ़िकल्टी नहीं होती हमें पेशेंट को केयर करने में. पेशेंट खाली हाथ आते हैं यहाँ पे. कोई कास्ट नहीं देखी जाती यहाँ पे, ना कोई पेशेंट का स्टेटस देखा जाता है यहाँ पे. सभी पेशेंट को बराबर ट्रीटमेंट मिलता है. तो यहाँ पे मैंने बहुत ऐसे पेशेंट देखे हैं जो क्रिटिकल सिक पेशेंट आते हैं, अनकॉन्शियस पेशेंट आते थे. और मैंने ICU में, CCU में और बाकी गायनी में काफ़ी जगह काम किया है. और जब वो ठीक होके जाते हैं तो बहुत ज़्यादा खुशी होती है. यस, टू मच एंजॉय. मेरे को कोई अगर यहाँ से बोले जाने के लिए तो मैं कभी नहीं सोचूंगी भी यहाँ से मैं जाऊँ, क्योंकि मेरा एम ही यही है, मैं पेशेंट के साथ रहूँ और उनकी सेवा करूँ.
Even though we are a charitable organization, our staffing ratios are very similar to any good private or public healthcare facility. Our manpower, our doctors, our nurses and support staff are mostly people who've come from very good qualifications and background, who've come and joined a charitable organization because they're committed to serve. They want to be able to use their skills in a non-commercial environment and take care of people who come through their door. There is no financial motive, there is no other personal motive but to take care of society. What I've noticed is the staff actually becomes your extended family. And very often you've seen patients want to stay on a day or two, even after they've healed, because they're so comfortable in that healthcare environment. So the system we have in MJS is designed to make sure that the patients get complete care and come back to full recovery. We have to remember that people who are coming to us as patients who get admitted actually are perhaps earning their daily bread from their day's work. So every day out of service for them is a loss of revenue in some ways, is a loss of income. So we want to make sure that they are healthy enough to get back to work the soonest that they can, because otherwise their families are out of food in some cases.
Doctor ne inni take care main kahe hospital se kithe nahi dekhi main mere ko lafz nahi jinna naal main da kinni da ethe di sukh sahulatan di vadai kar sakan odon kitte upar big upma karenge humne pehle bhi bahut sare hospital dekhe bada kuch duniya mein dekha 72 year I am old but jo ye hai ye ek vilakhan deen hai mabiyan ne jo ajhe tak mainu te nahi japi ke ਇਹ ਉਹਦੀ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਹੋਵੇ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਧੰਨਵਾਦ
One of the greatest challenges is the shortage of trained medical staff available to work at rural hospitals. The appeal of city life is hard to resist, especially for the younger generation of doctors. While the hospitals at Bahota and Sikandarpur are modern and well-equipped, sadly, they still cannot provide all the services due to a lack of doctors.
Yeah, that is the biggest frustration. Not only for the patients, for us also. When we feel a little, that we are not able to satisfy to the desired extent. Some people, some doctors, some medicos, some other persons who get inspired to come over and join this, it'll be a great help. Then, yes, the patient will be able to get more and more benefit, the optimal benefit out of this huge infrastructure which has been created.
Specialist doctors from Bias and other hospitals in Delhi visit the Bahota and Sikandarpur hospitals on a voluntary basis to offer their medical services periodically. One such doctor is Dr. Malik, an orthopedic surgeon who drives from Delhi to Sikandarpur regularly to attend to patients.
The work environment, the energy, the kind of cooperation, and the cleanliness in the hospital, I mean, it's nowhere to be seen, in fact. I was looking for a hospital where I could give my services as a charitable. And when I approached them, they received me with open arms. And the administration has been very, very cooperative. They gave me all support, anesthesia support and otherwise also. And this area has actually a lot of poor, very, very poor patients, in fact, who even can't afford to come by transport. They don't have even 2-3 rupees to come. Such a population it is catering to. And obviously they are unable to go to a private practitioner. They just go to those bone setters, and some of them will become all right, and some of them they don't heal, or they heal in a wrong direction. I mean, the bones unite in abnormal positions, and their life is affected badly, very badly because of that.
ये मैंने आपका एक्सरे देख लिया है और आपको मैंने चेक भी कर लिया है वो जल्दी चलने की वजह से ये रॉड टूट गई आपकी और हड्डी जुड़ी नहीं है अभी सो इसको दोबारा ऑपरेशन होगा इसका ठीक है। और कुछ पूछना चाहते हैं? इसमें प्लेट लगाई जाएगी, ठीक है, और स्क्रू डालेंगे इसमें रॉड निकाल के, ठीक है। उसके बाद आपको रेस्ट करना है 3-4 महीने, जब तक जुड़ नहीं जाएगी, आपकी बार चलने नहीं देंगे आपको बिल्कुल, क्योंकि रॉड में तो फिर जल्दी चला देते हैं, लेकिन प्लेट में हम थोड़ा देर से चलाते हैं पेशेंट्स को, ठीक है।
मैं आ रहा था सिरसा से जी, तो रास्ते में ब्रेक फेल हो गई गाड़ी की, सिरसा ले गए फिर यहाँ, तो उन्होंने रॉड पाई दाखिल किया, बहुत खर्चा आ जाता जी, 60-65 हज़ार रुपया लग गया। फिर उन्होंने चलन का क्या सी, जल्दी चल पेगा, और रॉड टुट गई,
रॉड
टुटन तो बाद उन्होंने फिर कुछ नहीं किया, फिर कहते दोबारा कढ़नी पवेगी। मैं ही कमाई करता, मैं ही सब कुछ, जो बच्चे पढ़ाई खर्चा वगैरह सब मैं ही निकालता हूँ। तो भी अच्छे डॉक्टर साहब हर साल आते हैं, डॉक्टर साहब पता नहीं भगवान ने भेजे हैं, पता नहीं मेरे लिए भेजे हैं।
द मोमेंट दे कम टू नो दैट यू नो देयर इज अ ऑर्थोपेडिक डॉक्टर इज कमिंग, दे जस्ट रश टू द हॉस्पिटल। Actually, whenever I have come here to operate the patients, in fact, I myself felt I am a changed person, you know. And the kind of ease which I feel during surgery here, that I have never felt at my own place. I mean, something is there. In fact, whenever I have come here for seva, na, I get a lot of happiness and I get a lot of peace, which I can't explain actually. It's a totally different place. And the patients, they have so much of faith on you, and faith itself is a great power. It works automatically. And their surgery goes very well, and the infection rate is almost nil. The complication rate is almost nil here. And I have felt very happy, in fact, always. Whenever I have come here, I don't feel like going back. The patients are being given food and everything, all care by the sevadars. They are being taken care of by the sisters very well. Even the sisters are very much trained here. They will not call you for minor problems. They handle themselves. And I think it's the best place, I would say, to work.
Another doctor from Delhi, who recently volunteered to work at the Sikandarpur Hospital, shares her thoughts on the difference between city versus rural medical care.
I am a practicing ophthalmologist in Delhi, and I had an opportunity to visit Sikandarpur Hospital for the purpose of seva last week, and I would like to share my experience about the place. So I guess Sikandarpur is the best example in terms of you have a very good campus. The accommodation is excellent. The food, the mess, bhojan bandar, everything is just perfect. The amount of trust the patient have in the countryside area is nothing compared to the city. In the countryside, there the patients put the entire amount of trust in you. So you feel like doing more than what you know for the patients. So at the end of the day, it is good both for the doctors and for the patients.
Recently, a renowned laparoscopic surgeon from Mumbai offered to organize a bariatric and laparoscopic camp at Bias Hospital. It was the first such camp to ever be set up at the Bias Hospital.
And that's when I came across Babaji and my first experience with him. He came across as quite a dynamic personality, someone who was heading such a big religious trust, which I only came to know much later. But when I came here, I visited the hospital and I promised him that I'd do something. Most of the times you don't get to hear of high-end surgeries being done at most of these camps. You hear of basic surgeries being done. So what we thought we'd do is we'd try and take it a notch higher. This is the first such camp that we've done here. So it's early days, and we thought we'd start off by doing few cases. So we've done 16 cases this time, and next time we can throw in cancer surgeries, we can throw in many more surgeries. And I can't really ever think of any bariatric camp which has ever been done on a charity basis. So this is the first time in a lot of ways. Most importantly, we must remember that whenever you come to a private hospital, invariably one thing you have to understand in mind, it's commercial. So this is the only place where when you walk into the hospital, you know it's not commercial. So whatever a doctor tells you, at least it won't be a commercial bent of mine. So you get that part out of your system. And then if you can do the top-end surgeries in such a setup, I think it's a win-win situation. I think for most poor patients, and I do believe this truly, that most poor people need the best skill sets that there are available because they continue with their problems longer, they tend to hold on to their pain for longer, only because they don't have the money or the wherewithal to go to some of the best doctors. And unfortunately, because of that, they don't get the best kind of medical advice. I think we as doctors owe it to our whatever we've learned. We've probably learned it from government and municipal hospitals to try and treat these poor patients. I think when we become top of the tops in our field, we should give it back to them. So we should keep doing these things. I think one thing that I noticed about the Bias Hospital is probably the cleanest and the best laid out hospital that I've seen amongst many in the world. There are open spaces for the patients to come in and sit. One great thing that I noticed was there were no mobile phones. And I think that's a fantastic thing because most of the times we get so clued by the gizmos of the world that we forget that we are patients eventually and we need that time and rest off. So I think it's a great concept and I think it should be taken up by some of the other hospitals across the world. So my only piece of advice to most people who are doing really well in medicine is give back. Because when you give back, you realize you get much, much more out of it than you've actually given. It might take you a little bit of time, but once you realize that you give back, you keep doing it on a regular basis, you start enjoying it. And the challenges that come with rural care is completely different from the challenges that come with urban care. But I think a rural care model would teach you much, much more, give you much, much more satisfaction than any kind of money in an urban care would give you. Because trust me, when you want to hang up your boots, there'll be more satisfaction when you've given back rather than taken from society.
Dr. Jagat Ram, a renowned eye surgeon who has performed more than 80,000 cataract surgeries, voluntarily offers his services to the society to treat patients regularly. He shares his knowledge and extensive experience with other ophthalmologists at the hospital. On one occasion, Hazur Maharaji expressed his appreciation on the dedication of the hospital staff.
It's a very beautiful dream work, and they are rendering good service to the masses. And even the people, non-satsangis, appreciate with the dedication in which the whole hospital is working for the benefit of the sick and the poor people, especially for the destitutes, whom nobody would have bothered about. We have 50 private wards. Nobody goes to private ward because services in the general ward is so good that nobody wants to go to the private ward at all. And one VIP came and the administrator showed him the general ward. He said, yes, yes, I have seen the private ward with your general ward. So that much efficiency is there. Absolutely neat, clean. Everybody is a VIP there.
As more and more people opted to stay in the general wards, the private wards became redundant and were eventually phased out. The hospitals have been built to be energy efficient and environmentally friendly. The entire facility was designed to provide natural light and fresh air. During the construction of the Bias Hospital, Hazur Maharaji asked the landscape architect, "How much lawn can you put here?" The architect replied, "As much as you want." Hazur Maharaji said, "Generally, people like to sit outside to recuperate, so we want as much lawn as possible. As you know, the sun is a great healer." And today, we can see how the patients enjoy the beautifully manicured lawns and absorb the peaceful atmosphere surrounding the hospital. Hazur Maharaj's vision was not just to set up a beautiful hospital for the patients, but to build a campus with an excellent infrastructure so that those who choose to work in the hospital are provided with all the basic needs. All the hospital campuses have housing and a variety of facilities so that staff and their families need not travel for their general needs. Doctors, nurses, and their families meet regularly in the evenings and enjoy their leisure time together in beautiful surroundings. Children of the hospital staff are given the opportunity to study at the newly opened Path Seekers School at Dera Bias, a beautiful campus providing high-quality education for children aged 18 months and upwards. In addition, students who opt for higher education are provided with financial assistance by the society. One doctor sums it up beautifully.
When we have been assigned certain duties to take care of the patients, we are taking care of the patients. Now, all other things, all other requirements of ours are taken care of. The perks, the sort of accommodation that we get, the furnishings, the backup. Now I'm talking about the non-medical things. All things are available in the colony. Requirements, the general store, the provision store, the mill stores, the canteens, the fruit and vegetable shop. You name it and it's there. Facilities for the barber, facilities for the tailor, the gas requirement, your gas supply. You've got 24/7 electricity supply. You've got clean drinking water. You've got hygienic surroundings to live in. There's no pollution. Now, that is just for the social part, your requirements, the family requirements. When I'm working in the medicine, my other requirements are also taken care of. The backup that I get, the laundry services, the workshops, the central stores, you name it, the supplies are there. The requirements of the patients are fully satisfied.
This is like Washington for us. This is like Los Angeles for us. So it's best of life, best of quality of life. The ambience, the seva, the spirit of seva, and everybody there to help you. We are like a family. A family is not confined to two people, three people, four people, five people. It's a whole family. So whatever the colony residents, number of people who are here, they're all part of the family. It's an extended family. It's excellent. I would grade it as excellent.
With the expansion of Dera and the growth of the visiting Sangat, the need for a hospital within the Dera became increasingly necessary. In 2002, a two-story primary care hospital opened at the Dera, where approximately 1 million patients with common ailments, routine illnesses and injuries are treated annually. The hospital has 24-hour emergency facilities, several outpatient departments, and an inpatient facility. A dispensary provides free medicines to all patients. The Dera residents can choose between allopathic and homeopathic treatments. Physiotherapy and dental care are also available to them. Not far from the Dera Hospital is the Nature Cure Clinic, which was founded in 1965 by Hazur Maharaj's wife, Mrs. Harjeet Grewal. Here, naturopathic treatments and yoga classes are offered to Dera residents. With millions of people visiting Dera, community healthcare is a necessity. The Dera Hospital regularly tests food and water samples to ensure it is hygienic and safe for consumption. during large satsang gatherings at the Dera, where there is an attendance of up to 500,000 people, and during the Master's official satsang programs all over India, first aid posts are conveniently located at the satsang sheds, where volunteer doctors and nurses are equipped to handle emergency situations. In some centers, the first aid unit is open throughout the night during the entire satsang program. In addition, every national center has a dispensary and provides emergency services. Over the years, the society has raised public awareness of the growing need for organ donation. It has awakened countless people to the immense service this one act of compassion can bestow on suffering humanity.
So, ya to ye aankhe aag mein jalkar raakh ho jayengi ya mitti mein milkar mitti. Agar ye aankhe kisi zaruratmand ko mil jaye to use roshni milegi. Jeevan bhar ka andhkar dur ho jayega. To aap hi bataiye aklmandi kisme hai? Aankhe raakh karne mein या किसी बिना आंख वाले को रोशनी देने में.
One of the many free services provided by the Dera Hospital is the annual medical checkup for all sevadars and their families, as well as all permanent Dera residents. In this week-long medical camp, hundreds of doctors, nurses, and specialists from all over India provide extensive health screening to approximately 4,000 people, which includes 1,200 children. Some of these include blood tests, ECG exams, echocardiography, bone density, cancer screening, well woman examinations, and hearing and vision tests. In the laboratory, technicians analyze all test samples and results are delivered overnight. Specialists provide individual consultations free of charge. Seminars are also provided to promote healthy living, and dietitians offer nutritional consultations based on individual medical needs. Hazur Maharaj Ji often said that as human beings, we are meant to help each other. He would say that even for our enemies in misery, there should be tears in our eyes, because when a person's heart is filled with love for the Lord, then the whole world becomes his family.
If we can do anything to help anybody, we should. That is our duty. We are meant to help each other. Humans are meant to help humans. Who else will help? Birds and lions won't come to help you. You have to help each other. We should have to be source of strength to each other. Swamiji says, Komal Chit Daya Man Taro. Your heart should be very, very soft to other people. And you should be very compassionate, very kind. You see, these qualities automatically come in you when you are filled with the love and devotion for the Father. Because then you see the Father in everybody.
In addition to providing free medical care, the Maharaj Jagat Singh Medical Relief Society has always offered immediate relief and aid to victims during major calamities in India, providing life-saving donations of food, water, shelter, clothing, and medical care. In 2001, during the Gujarat earthquake, volunteers helped to construct 69 earthquake-resistant schools within 7 months. In 2005, when a devastating earthquake hit Jammu and Kashmir, hundreds of sevadars helped to construct sheds in 11 locations within 40 days. Speed was imperative here as the winter was setting in and people needed immediate shelter. Each shed was fully insulated against hot and cold climates and included a living space, a kitchenette, and bathroom facilities. In 2010, when Leh was hit by flash floods, hundreds died and thousands were left homeless. The National Disaster Management Authority made an urgent request to the society to provide shelters for those who had lost their homes. Over a period of 4 weeks, volunteers gathered to construct insulated sheds. In April 2015, Nepal was hit by an earthquake measuring 7.8 on the Richter scale. It was one of the most severe earthquakes on record. 8 million people were affected. The society immediately opened its Kathmandu center to provide food and shelter for the homeless. In addition, thousands of volunteers were sent to construct 20 sheds with bathroom facilities. These sheds eventually served a dual purpose: shelters by night and schools by day. During all the relief efforts, sevadars worked round the clock under harsh conditions to help their fellow man in a time of need. It was a perfect example of selfless service as taught by the spiritual masters of Bias. Humanity simply means love for the Lord and His creation. The hospital is simply a venue, one of many in this vast universe where there is ample opportunity to show kindness and compassion. Those who serve here are simply examples of ordinary people making an effort to ease the pain and suffering of their fellow man. But whether one serves as a doctor or nurse, or just as an ordinary person, when such service is done with a humble heart, for the sake of love and love alone, then man has risen up to his true calling. He has taken the first step in becoming a good human being.
कृपा करो दीन के दाते मेरा गुण अवगण ना बिचारो कोई कृपा करो दाते माटी का क्या तो पैसोमी मानस की गत ए कृपा करो दीन के दा